First question.
I heard so many international financial company come to Luxembourg because of Brexit. So what is the reason?
Well, Luxembourg is a leading international financial services center. It is the number one in Europe when it comes to investment funds. Uh-huh. When you look at the assets under management, it's an important private banking center. Uh-huh. And it is a very open-minded and technology-friendly country. Uh-huh. That is true in general, but also in particular when it comes to financial services. Uh-huh. With a license of the Luxembourg authorities, you can sell your financial services and products to all the member countries of the European Union. And it has built a high ecosystem of highly qualified banks, lawyers, audit companies, and so on. And in that context, of course, fintech for us is a normal evolution of financial services. You mentioned PayPal. PayPal already before people spoke about fintech, Luxembourg issued a full banking license to PayPal because we believe in technology. And we think that what is now possible with blockchain will be something that will be further addition to the services that can already be offered out of Luxembourg. We use the current laws that we have to see to what extent can we be technology friendly, but by using the existing laws. And that has worked quite well, and PayPal was the first example, but that was more than 10 years ago, yeah, when I was still Minister of Finance, uh-huh, and I issued that license. The first country to authorize platforms that allow the exchange of normal currencies, of traditional currencies, into cryptocurrencies. Mm-hmm. So Bitstamp and Bitflyer are companies that received the license from the Luxembourg authorities as payment services companies. Because we believe in new technological developments, mm-hmm, we think that indeed with blockchain we can develop new possibilities for investors and for channeling funds into the international market.
Why Chinese bank come to here? Same reason?
Exactly for the same reasons, because we are thinking cross-border. Mm. If you go to some of the larger countries in Europe, their main focus is their national market. Mm-hmm. The largest Chinese banks all chose Luxembourg as their European headquarters, because, again, they know that this is a business-friendly international environment where cross-border is a key element of the laws, but also of the mentality. Mm. We try to speak the languages of the clients. The authorities accept that the documents are filed in German, in French, in English. So it's very multinational, and the people that are working here are also used to multilingual and multicultural environments. Our market is not our country, but our market is Europe, our market is the world. That's why the leading Asian, American, European financial institutions have set up their headquarters in Luxembourg to do business all over Europe. Mm. A few weeks ago, the Luxembourg Parliament adopted a law that clarifies the situation of securities that are held in digitalized registers, in electronic registers, so to make sure that the law also recognizes blockchain and similar technologies when it comes to dealing in securities. Mm. Luxembourg grows currently much faster than most of the other European economies. The growth rate of Luxembourg of the past 10 years has been twice as high as one of the other countries of the European Union. Mm. And we are very optimistic that that will continue to be like that.